Today we are going to solve some more problems of NEET Phase 2 2016 chemistry paper. We have already solved question number up to 78 and now we are going to solve question number 79. And the question number 79 is, in pyrrole the structure is given as, this is the pyrrole structure, and here numbering is given as, numbering is done as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in this way. The electron density is maximum, the electron density is maximum at, the options are, first option is 2 and 3, second option is 3 and 4, third option is 2 and 4, and fourth option is 2 and 5. And if you look at the option here, the correct answer will be 4, 2 and 5. 2 and 5, at 2 and 5 position electron density will be maximum. So how it will be decided? It will be decided on the basis of relative stability of canonical structure of pyrrole. So if you look at the canonical structure of pyrrole, we have following canonical structure of pyrrole here. So first of all, lone pair of nitrogen is donated to this one. So the electronic transition will form this compound here first. First of all, I am writing the all other molecule or atom, all other atom and double bond, single bond, which are not participating in resonance. And now here you can easily see that nitrogen is giving electrons, so it will have plus and it will have minus with double bond here, because electron is donated here. So this is the second chemical structure. Now if we write the next chemical structure, you will see that electron will move in this way, this one and this one. So now we will have this structure here. Again I am writing all the structure as it is, which are not participating in the resonance, but after then this one, we have this one and this one. You can see that plus minus are at adjacent position here, but there is no possibility of double bond formation here, because if double bond is formed, nitrogen get sp hybridization. And in cyclic structure up to 7 membrane, there is no sp carbon sp atom possible because of pi angle strain. So now again resonance will happen between this one and this one, and if this will happen in this one and this one, so we will have next chemical structure as this one. Sorry, next chemical structure as this one, nitrogen plus. And here we have, you can say that I am just starting the other bond which are not participating in the structure bonding, and this one minus. And now here we will have this one. Next chemical structure, you can see that we'll have this one, N plus H, double bond minus and double bond. And now if we do resonance in this way, you will get the first structure. So you will have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the 5 canonical structure for pyrrole. Now stability order of the canonical structure, first of all we have to see number of bonds. Since number of bonds are equal in all structure, so it will not decide the stability order. So then after, a bond, a structure without charge distribution is more stable. So one is more stable than all other has plus minus distribution. Now among plus minus the structure, you can see that here we have plus minus at 1, 2, 3, 1, 3 position. Here we have plus minus at 1, 2 position. So you must be knowing the rule that plus minus distribution at nearer position will be more stable because of more attractive nature of attractive bonding between plus and minus. So 3 is more stable, and similarly you can see that 4 is more stable. 3 and 4 are actually identically stable because both are identical structure. Now you can see that 2 and 5 are identical structure. 2 and 5 are equally stable. So among these, among the given option, you can easily see that if we do minus charge on 2 and 5, this is the second position, or you can say the 5 position, and this is the second position. So at 2 and 5, the electron density is more stable, minus charge is more stable, and that's why electron density is maximum at 2 and 5 position. So this is the question number 79. The next question is question number 80. And question number 80 is, which of the following compounds shall not react with, shall not produce propene? Compound which reaction with HBr is not giving is not giving propene, we have to decide which compound is this one. First option is cyclopropane, second option is CH3CH2CH2OH, third option is CH2 double bond C double bond O, and fourth option is CH3CH2CH2Br. So if we react it with HBr, it will getting CH2CH3CH2HBr, because it is pi bond character, and then after elimination we will have CH3CH double bond CH2 propene. Here again elimination can take place directly or by bromination, followed by or first by bromination and then by elimination, you will get CH3CH double bond CH2. Here you can easily see that HBr or elimination will not going to proceed propene. So the correct answer is this one. Here also elimination will simply form propene. So among the given option, you can easily see that CH2 double bond C double bond O will give the structure propene. Will give the propene compound here. The next compound is question number 81. And question number 81 is which of the following nitro compound does not react with nitrous acid? Nitro compound doesn't react with HNO2. Options given are, first option is CH3CH2CH2NO2. Second option is CH3CH3CH2NO2. Third option is CH3CH3NO2. And fourth option is CH3 C double bond O CH CH3 and NO2. So these are the compound here, and we have to decide which compound doesn't react with HNO2. Correct answer will be this one, because RCH2NO2 react with HON double bond O as follows: 2 hydrogen from this position will be eliminated by addition of this one, this hydrogen oxygen, and the structure formed will be equal to C double bond O NOH, and this is going to be equal to NO2. Now if we have RCH in RCHR dash and NO2, and here again we have HON double bond O, so we have a structure as follows. You can see that this hydrogen will be eliminated by this OH, and if we eliminate this one, we have RCR dash N double bond O and then NO2. So primary, you can say that primary nitro compound or secondary nitro compound can easily react with HNO2, but if you look at the R, that is CH3CH3, in this case there is no hydrogen present at alpha position of nitro group, and that's why there is no reaction between this compound, tertiary nitro compound, with HNO2, and that's why 3 is the correct answer here. The next question, 82. Question 82 is, the central dogma of molecular genetics states the genetic information flows from. It is a question of biology here. Genetic information flows as follows. From which one to which one genetic information follow? Amino acid to protein to DNA. Second option is DNA, and then carbohydrates, and then proteins. Third option is from DNA and then RNA and then proteins. Actually, this is the correct options. First of all, genetic information passes from DNA and then RNA and then protein. So this is the correct answer. Fourth one is DNA, RNA, carbohydrate. So this is wrong. Carbohydrate has no role in passing the genetic information. Basically, the genetic information flows from DNA, RNA, and then protein. So, this is the central dogma of molecular genetics states. Molecular genetics states that the genetic information flows from molecular dogma of central dogma of molecular genetics from DNA to RNA to proteins. The next question is question number 83, and question number 83 is, we have been given four compounds here. Compounds are as follows. We have given four compounds here, and compounds are as follows. I am just writing the compound first. And the HOH position are as follows. HOH here, and then OH, H here. Now OH, H here, H, OH here, and now H, OH here, and now H, OH here. So respectively, name of these four compounds respectively is, first option is L tetrose D, sorry, L throws L it throws and then D T H E T H R E O S E. So these are the four names. First option is this one, the second one is D throws, D it throws, and then L throws, and then L throws. Third one is L it throws, L throws, D it throws, and D throws. Fourth one is D it throws, and then D throws, and then L it throws, and then L T H R E O S E. This one. Actually, tetrose and throws nomenclature is valid for two asymmetric center with two similar group and two dissimilar group. Two same group and two different group. So here you can see that two same group are present, HOH at both asymmetric carbon, and two different group is present. You can also see it, CHO and C2H. One is this one and one is this one. So two same group are present. Now, if same group are on same side, it throws and throws nomenclature or naming is valid on two C star, on two C star with two same group and two different group. Now the rule is, if same group are on same side, it is called it throws. It throws. And if same group are on opposite side, it is called throws. So you can easily see that this is throws, this is throws. These two are throws. Now we have to decide either it is D or L. So if, for D or L configuration, you have to apply the D or L configuration on last symmetric center. So it is a 3 holes. It is clear that it is 3 holes. It is also a 3 holes because the same group are on same side. And it is L. You can see that it is D and it is L. So this is D trios, this is L trios, this is D trios, and this is L trios. So the correct answer is 4-1. First of all, trios and trios nomenclature is valid if a compound has two asymmetric centers with two same group. HOH are same group. So and now if same group are on same side, that is called trios. And same group are on opposite side, then it is called trios. Now DL configuration is assigned on the last symmetric carbon atom, and on last symmetric carbon you can see that D, this is the D form, this is the D form, this is the L form, this is the L form. So the correct answer will be 4th one, where it is given that the correct option is given as 4th one. The next question is question number 84, and question number 84 is, the reaction is given as this one, is reacting with this one in presence of HF at 0 degree Celsius, and the product is P is, option 1 is given as this one, option 2 is given as this one, option 3 is given as this one, and option 4 is given as option 4 is given as this one. So these are the four options here, and we have to decide which is the correct option here. So if you look at the option here, the correct option for the product P will be this one. Basically what happens here is we have benzene ring here, and when it will react with HF, it is going to form this one, H plus will attack, and this will going to form this one, and now it will attack on this one, and it, in this way you can easily see that the formation of product will happen as this one. Electrophilic aromatic association will occur, and the bond product will be third one. So this is the answer here, this is the question number 84. The next question is question 85, and question 85 is, question 85 is, it is told that a given nitrogen containing aromatic compound A, it is aromatic nitrogen containing compound, A is aromatic nitrogen containing compound, it react with SNHCl, it react with SNHCl followed by HNO2, followed by HNO2, and then after HNO2 is reacted here, written here in B, it is unstable compound, and now B on treatment with phenol, PHOH, it forms a beautiful color compound C with molecular formula C12H10N2O. The compound A is option is aniline, first one option is, second option is nitrobenzene, third option is benzene nitrile, and fourth option is benzamide. So these are the four options, and we have to decide which is the correct option here. So first of all, it is a nitrobenzene, and if it is reacting with SNHCl, it is going to form aniline first, and now it will react with HNO2, It will going to form diazonium salt, which is an unstable compound. It is an unstable compound here. Now, if we react it with PHOH, PHOH will attack in this way. Coupling reaction will happen, and we will have compound as follows: N double bond N. Coupling reaction will occur from para position of the benzene ring. So first of all, I am writing in this way, and coupling will occur from para position of benzene ring in this way. We have this binocular structure, and this will be equal to C12H10N2O. You can easily see it. So the compound is clearly nitrobenzene. You can easily see that the compound will be nitrobenzene. The next question is question number 86, and question number 86 is: consider the reaction. We have been given a reaction here. A reaction CS3CH2CH2Br is reacting with NaCN to form CS3CH2CH2CN plus NaBr. It is clearly SN2 reaction because cyanide is a very good nucleophile. It is SN2 mechanism. The reaction will be is fastest in first option is ethanol, second option is methanol, third option is water, and fourth option is DMF, N dash dimethyl formamide DMF. If you look at the reaction here, you can easily see that it is a SN2 reaction. It is a SN2 reaction. Reaction is SN2 type. Cyanide has attack here, and cyanide has attack here, and Br minus has removed here. So it is a SN2 reaction. And if SN2 reaction about SN2 reaction, you must be knowing that SN2 reaction will be fastest in non-polar solvent. So this is the correct answer. Non-polar solvent. Non-polar solvent DMF will be the best for SN2 reaction because nucleophilic strength will be maximum in non-polar solvent. So now the next question is question number 86, 87, and the question is 87 number question is: the correct structure of the product A formed in the reaction is, the reaction is given as this one, and we have to add H2 gas at 1 atm in presence of palladium, carbon, ethanol, and the product A is first option is given as this one. It means that reduction of carbonyl carbon has happened. Second option is given as this one, that is reduction of alkene has happened. Third one is this one, and fourth one is this one. So if you look at the palladium catalyst, it is a Lindahl catalyst, which is a simple reducing agent catalyst for reduction of double bond. So double bond will be simply reduced. Carbonyl carbon will not reduce in this case. So the correct answer will be this one, cyclohexanone. Next to question number 88, and the question number 88 is: which of the following can exhibit tautomerism? Can exhibit tautomerism? Tautomerism. The compounds given are, this is the first compound given here. The first compound given here. PH is the second compound given here. This is the third compound given here. Options are third only, second one is both 1 and 3, third one is both 1 and 2, and fourth one is both 2 and 3. Among these, we have to decide which will exhibit tautomerism. If you know the tautomerism, you must be knowing that in tautomerism, enol will form and double bond will form at adjacent carbon. You can see that it is a 3D bridged position. It is a 3D bridged position. 3D bridged position, and on 3D bridged position, no double bond can form. On 3D bridged, double bond can't be formed. Double bond can't be formed. On 3D bridged position, on 3D bridged, double bond can't be formed, and that's why here double bond will not form, because it's alpha position in bridged, no double bond formation is possible. It's alpha position in one bridged and one this one. There is no hydrogen here, so no tautomerization is possible also here. Here you can see that one alpha position is bridged. There is no alpha double bond formation possible from this position. However, from this position you can see that there are two hydrogen here which can undergo tautomerism, and that's why tautomerism is possible in third only. There is no tautomerism possible in first and second compound. You can easily see that. The next question is question number 89. And the question number 89 is, the correct order of acidic strength among, first one is this one, second one is this one, and third one is this one, first, second and third. Among the given option, we have to decide which is correct, first, second, third. Second option is 2, third 1, third option is 3, 2, 1, and fourth option is 2, 1, 3. Among the given option, we have to decide which is the correct answer here. If you look at the position here, you will see that oxygen has minus I effect. Here also oxygen has minus I effect. And minus I effect that is acceptor tendency. Acceptor group will increase acidic strength. There is no doubt about it. And also minus I effect is strength dependent. It means that if minus I is nearer to COOH group, it will increase acidic strength by larger amount. So 2 has maximum acidic strength, and then 3 and then 1. So the correct answer will be 2, 3, 1. This is the correct answer here. Minus I is acceptor group, it will increase acidic strength, no doubt. Further, minus I is strength dependent, that is nearer a group nearer to COOH group will produce minus I effect to larger extent, and that's why acidic strength of this particular compound will be maximum. Question number 90. The question number 90 is, the compound that will most readily react with gaseous bromine. The compound which react most radially with gaseous bromine has formula, first option is C3H6, second option is C2H2, third option is C4H10, and fourth option is C2H4. So these are the options here. We will decide which will form, which will react gaseous bromine with large extent. If you look at this one, there is no reaction of gaseous bromine to this one. This is this one. So if we react bromine here, so you will have carbocation formed. This one. If we react bromine here, you will have carbocation formed as this one. This is going to form this one. If we react this one, we have carbocation formed as this one. Among the given option, you can see that will react with bromine to larger extent, fast phase, which will form more stable carbocation. So more stable carbocation is this one. And if it is more stable, it means that this compound will be more reactive toward reaction with gaseous bromine, and that's why this is the correct answer. C3H6, which has one double bond, will react with gases bromine to the fastest rate. So in this way we have solved problems of chemistry of NEET 2016 of phase 2.